it's a beautiful day at Windward School. Down to college. Grades are okay. I still have that rash, but there's 2 weeks left of school. Put in park.
What word would I use to describe this year's senior class? Well, unique comes to mind. It's full of artists, actresses, athletes, musicians, Darren. But this class is really seriously, it's really like just one of a kind. But, you know, that's not necessarily a positive thing.
What do I think of my class this year?
What do you want?
They really love clapping for me. It kind of gets old very fast. Actually, it's really annoying. But they know how to waste time, I'll give them that.
Why do I clap for Ryan? Is that a joke? I clap for Ryan because he's an honest man. He's a great man, and he's from the future.
I mean, I only do it because Griffin does it.
I only do it because Jack does it.
I have no idea what's going on.
It's getting pretty excessive.
I love you, Ryan Stoddy.
Windward has been a fantastic experience for me and definitely very rewarding. You know, as one of the smartest kids in the school, I've had to carry my fair share of other kids through some of the classes over the years.
No, you're doing it all wrong. Trust me, the answer is 4.3, like my GPA.
This is my art homework.
I'm Ben Krieger!
Of course I'm not mad that Ben is considered the smartest kid in school. Why would you even ask me that? God, like, who cares, you know? Just whatever.
You're asking about college.
Wait, can I be a double stuff Oreo or just a normal one?
No. You can be a double stuff and a normal one. But
Leo, what about you? What are you doing?
I hack for the people. The Sony scandal? Yeah, that wasn't very good.
Alex and Marcus.
Who do you work for?
I didn't tell you how fire your outfit was today during jazz.
Thank you.
I was focused on the listening and stuff.
So prom is coming up, and there are a lot of unique promposals here and there, but some are more complex than others.
So for my promposal, I'm asking Olivia with a fun math equation that I wrote her, because I know she loves math.
Hey, Brendan, will you help me with this math problem?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Thanks.
You just forgot to carry the one. And oh yeah, sure, I'll go to prom with you.
Okay, Gabby, so anytime you need to, nutrition or lunch, just come in and I'll be happy to show you how to set up a mic, okay?
Perfect. Great. Okay, thank
All right.
Dr. Bruce.
All right, sweetheart, see you soon. Oh, that's right, I'm a doctor of music.
Hey, Dr. Bruce.
Hey, Ryan, what's up?
I did have this small wart that might possibly be infected. I was hoping maybe you could take a look at it.
All right, bring it over. Let's take a look at it.
Don't get me wrong. I love the Newman. He's just really hard to find, especially when you need him. I mean, he must be a really busy guy.
No, I don't ignore my students. I mean, I love my students. It's just coincidence that I happen to be busy when they stop by. I would never intentionally miss them. One second. Sorry, where were we? So my students, I wish they came by more often. I mean, I would really love to have the time with them, but they just don't seem to come by as much as they used to.
Been here for 3 hours.
Oh, what happened to the grab and go?
You should have texted me. Like, I actually would have thought. Are you joking?
No, I'm serious.
Oh,
okay. I'm just going to Trader Joe's and picking up like, a bunch of stuff.
You should get some change in
my
wallet.
Yeah, yeah. You have the Windward credit card?
Why do I cut my pants? Are you kidding? I mean, well, obviously they're just like.
Cuffing your pants is the new it thing, you know? You either get it or you don't.
No. I will not cuff my pants. And let me tell you why. I absolutely refuse to be a part of this routine societal oppression of the proletariat through these mediums such as fashion and what they claim is high art, but is really just a method of keeping the people down.
Is that what he said? That guy.
Hey guys.
I don't have any money.
Yep.
Mom? No, can you pick me up? No, I didn't want my pants again. These two guys are bullying me and making fun of me. I don't know, maybe my pants they're too long or they're not. I knew we should have got the chinos. No, I'm sorry for bothering you at work. I really don't want to be at school anymore. These guys are bullying me.
What's up?
I know what you're thinking. I'm not a sellout.
Yeah, I think hardness is the best way to get inside a student's mind, to really get to hear what they're thinking, what they're feeling about a certain text. But, you know, that being said, there are always a couple of students who dominate discussion, but they usually have really great ideas and really wonderful responses to whoever objects to them. So it's almost like they anticipated what the other people in the room are going to say.
Look, I think when we're talking about Kafka's Metamorphosis, I think we have to keep in mind that it's about the Jewish identity. I mean, that transformation to a cockroach is very, very telling in Kafka's idea of society's thought about Judaism in general. Look, man, that is absolutely preposterous. If we're talking about Kafka, then it's obviously an argument about social classes. I mean, we're talking about the cockroach of society's ideals of the lower class, the struggle. I mean, I think it's very apparent. Personally, I think what you're saying is absolutely preposterous. I mean, Voltaire's Candide is definitely applicable here, and I think social class is just has nothing to do with this. I think when you analyze the text, all right, I think when we analyze the text here, I don't think Voltaire has anything to do with this book. Like, what are you saying?
Bernie Sanders.
Steve Jobs was Bill Gates. Nazi Germany 20 years in the future. I think Trump is a great candidate. And it comes to psychoanalytical, the feminist, that jet fuel cannot burn it. It's really a
We're going to our senior retreat.
So here we are at the Asilomar Conference Center. We just got here. Should be fun. See you later.
I do my best to find some kind of glow. I'm giving it some heart and soul now. From the darkest grays, the sun bursts, clouds break. Yeah, we see that fire from the streets of Babylon to the road that we've been on now. The kaleidoscope claims another. Some hope in me. The black and white set us free. Like the queen to the rook, your decision was a sure thing. Honey, yeah, a sure thing. No wonder I feel like I'm missing the heavy light.